there something you'd love to attract in your life? Well, coming up next, Andrea Woolf is the author of the book, Ignite Your Life, How to Get from Where You Are to Where You Want to Be. So I'd like you to meet the queen of having it all.
Are you struggling to find time and energy for your significant other or your children? Are you yearning for more in your life? Are you taking care of everyone but yourself? If this is you, then you've come to the right place. I'm Andrea Woolf, the queen of having it all, and the author of Ignite Your Life, How to Get from Where You Are to Where You Want to Be. I've been a business and personal coach for close to 20 years, and I've worked with thousands of people. From the time I was little, I would go to my mother's salon and would literally coach her clients. So I can truly say that for my whole life, I've been taking people from settling to sizzling. So what's causing the gap between where you are and where you want to be in your life? The shocking fact of the matter is this: you are the main reason you aren't getting the results you want, either from how you're thinking or how you're doing what you're doing in your life. Know that you absolutely can create success, joy, and fulfillment. All it takes is knowing how. My book, Ignite Your Life, is a simple step-by-step system that will create a profound shift in your life and will bring about the success, abundance, and joy that you've always dreamed of. Ignite Your Life takes you by the hand to uncover the limiting beliefs and fears that are keeping you stuck, help you easily manage your mind, and attract and achieve anything you want in your life and business starting today. Also, there are two amazing bonuses. Firstly, the Light Your Fire 30-Day Challenge. You'll be reminded each and every day how great life really can be when you're taking powerful steps towards what's most important to you. And secondly, a Have It All strategy session with me. You'll clarify where you would like to take your life to the next level and make significant changes. This entire amazing special package, which includes my book, The Light Your Fire 30-Day Challenge, and your Have It All strategy session, is just $9.97. Go to my website listed here to pick it up today.
It's a big question for many of you. How do you get from where you are in your life to where you truly want to be? Well, my guest today is an expert coach, Andrea Woolf, and she's the author of the book Ignite. And she's here to help us with these very steps. You know, how do we get our life on track with the life that we dream that we could be living? Welcome, Andrea.
Thank you, Kristen. Great to be with you.
So how do we do that?
Well, it starts with understanding what's got you where you are. Mm-hmm. What has been holding you back, whether it's external to you or inside you, inside that wonderful mind of yours. And often you have no idea that you've inherited certain beliefs about yourself and that you're living them out later in life, in your adult life. And so it's really important to clear all that out by really just getting in touch with it and getting clear. Once you've done that, then the world is your oyster. And the next step is to give yourself permission to actually dream up what it is you really, really want. And whilst that sounds incredibly simple, it's amazing how few people actually do it and, you know, just keep existing on automatic pilot in your life. So it's about creating vision. And when I say vision, I mean your ideal, amazing vision. So that when you're living that
big grand picture.
Exactly. So right. That it really sparkles, so that you're excited even in the process of creating it. And so to create your ideal vision, that picture of, for example, that magical relationship that you can hardly breathe at the thought of having that in your life. Or the business of your dream. So if you have a business, you might have got to that point where you're stuck, where it's reached a plateau. Well, what would absolutely be beyond your wildest dreams? And so many people get stopped by the fear of failure, by that fear of, well, what if I can't achieve it? And just don't go for it. So the bigger the dream, the easier it is to manifest, to actually cause to come into being.
That's great news. Yeah. So you're saying that the bigger the dream, so if we have a big, gigantic dream, it's actually easier?
Yes, it is, because you're going to have the energy to actually do it.
Mm-hmm. It's about getting your energy up and being excited by your life. And that way you will actually do it. Amazingly enough, it's not that, oh, the bigger the dream, the harder it will be to do. It's that you will actually, it'll start showing up in amazing, magical ways when you do this.
Well, let's talk about energy for a minute. I mean, we all hear about, you know, oh, that she has great energy or he has great energy or
yes.
I felt energetic that day. But what does that really look like, or how does that show up in someone's life?
So how it shows up is, so there are two aspects to life. There's the doing mm-hmm. and the being. And we forget this, you know, because we're human beings, not human doings.
Right.
And it's on the being side of it. So look at who you be in your life right now.
Who be ye?
Who be ye? Exactly. Who are you? And
right.
How are you showing up?
Mm-hmm.
Are you enthusiastic, for example?
Right.
What level of enthusiasm do you have for what is going on in your life right now? In your home, in your relationship, in your business, every single nook and cranny, how excited are you at where it's at right now? And I would guarantee that there are probably more than one areas where, you know, if you simply take 0 to 10, 0 is dire, couldn't be worse, 10 is like unbelievably amazing, perfect, couldn't be better. And you rate a particular area of your life on that scale, you're going to get a really very quick feel on where you are in that area. So let's say your business, it's okay. Maybe you're grateful that you're making it through these challenging times.
Right.
But it's not exciting, and you're not like leaping out of bed every morning to rush to the office to just keep bringing it on. Well, so what would 10 look like? And I mean 10, even 15 or 300. What would that look like? And then when you give yourself permission to start thinking like this, it causes, to use the name of this show, a ripple mm-hmm. both in you, it starts here, and then on out into the world. So just imagine, for example, you are suddenly excited about your business, and you walk into your office, and there your team are there to greet you. They are immediately going to feel the shift in you. And if you can articulate what your dream is,
right.
they're going to get equally excited, or at least the right ones will, the ones who will stay with you and belong with you, they will like then take on that excitement, and it becomes self-sustaining, and then it grows from there. I'm just picking one simple example. Inside a family, mm-hmm. let's say you're a mother, and you just feel like you're treading water in life.
No mothers ever feel like that, by the way. We're all excited and exuberant to change those diapers every morning.
Right. Or when your kids get a little older,
right?
And you're running in 12 directions with the kids all doing different things, and you're trying to keep your business going or your career, and you know, you're just a juggling act, basically.
Right.
So imagine if just with your children, never mind we dissect all the different parts and roles that you play, but just with your children, you take on being excited to be their mother, excited to like transmit this energy to them. Imagine who they are going to be when they get into school and when they get into the activities that they're doing. And maybe you have them, for example, helping in some charity, doing some, all of that energy ripples out onto the world. It is contagious, contagious, contagious.
Well, you raise, I think, such an important point, is that some characteristics that need to be present in your everyday life is enthusiasm and excitement. Like,
yes.
You need to bring those along with you, like one in each hip pocket.
Exactly.
Because that creates that magnetism to get things done that otherwise may make you feel in your life like you're stuck.
Exactly. So mm-hmm. energy isn't something external. Although we can feel each other's energy all the time.
Mm-hmm.
We're bouncing off each other positively or negatively, one way or the other.
Right.
So that's the reason it's very important to pay attention to who you surround yourself with. But that's for another topic.
So let me ask you a question. Have you ever noticed that where, you know, you're driving in to work and you're just in a bad mood that day? And then the whole day is like that.
Yes.
Like one thing happens after another after another. Is that part of what you're talking about?
It is. And it's what I call being on automatic pilot.
Mm-hmm.
So you always have choice. Whether you think you do or you think you don't, you always have choice. And the choice you have is how you choose to react to what's showing up in your life. So take that scenario you just described, Kristen,
mm-hmm.
where you're on the freeway, you're in a traffic jam, So you could choose to be angry, upset, just frustrated that I can't get where I'm going quickly enough, honking your horn like everybody around you. That is a choice. And equally, you have a choice to say, well, I'm not going anywhere anyway, so how can I make the most of this moment? Mm-hmm. You could maybe put on your favorite music. You could be listening to a really amazing motivational speaker who really lights up your heart and just inspires you to do great things as you, when you do eventually get to wherever you're going. There are always choices, and the assertion that I make is the ultimate choice you always have is how you react to what shows up in your life.
Right.
You have domain over yourself, always, if you choose to notice it.
Talk to me about passion. How important it is to be passionate about what you're doing in your life.
Well, I would say that it makes everything worthwhile. Mm-hmm. You can go at it from the glass half empty piece. Mm-hmm. Imagine a glass full of water and it's the half empty piece of the glass.
Right.
Where you're focusing on everything you don't have, everything you haven't done in your life, everything that you feel that you failed at, everything that's missing in any shape or form, emotionally or physically in your life. So you could focus there, and that will determine your experience of life. Because everything you touch, everything you do, every relationship you have, they're going to feel it. I mean, mm-hmm. Everyone will feel that way of being. I like to use the cast of characters of Winnie the Pooh.
Okay.
Because they're so simple and so clear. So, and my three favorites to use are Winnie the Pooh himself, the philosophical bear, who just floats through life and he finds meaning along the way. There's Piglet, who's like the Energizer Bunny, just sweet and innocent and loving life. And then there's Eeyore. Eeyore, the gray donkey, for whom life is hard. Shoulders are droopy, tail is droopy, and everything is gray. He sees the world through that filter called gray. It's never going to work. Who do you think you are? You know, that kind of filter. And that is a hard road to hoe. And yet, so many of you are doing it this way. So I would offer to you, if you just choose to take on the half full part of the glass, you're going to immediately have a whole different experience of the very same things that are currently in your life, mm-hmm. just by choosing where you focus. So if you look around your life right now, what are you grateful for? What is it that really is meaningful for you that you are grateful for? It could be that wonderful spouse of yours. It could be those precious children that you have, or your parents. My parents are 85. They're amazing. Mm-hmm. I am so blessed to have them. If you notice and don't take that for granted, it immediately starts to change how you see mm-hmm. your life. Suddenly, you're feeling gratitude all over the place. Again, that's another place to focus to completely change.
So let's say someone is sitting there watching our program in the morning, yes. and they're Eeyore. You know, they're just feeling down in the dumps. You know, you just feel like life is hard. Yes. What's a step that they could take right now, today, right now. To shift?
Yes. So pick one specific thing. See, when we're feeling gray, when you're feeling gray, it's... What the trap is to lump everything together so it becomes one big, huge gray mountain. Mm-hmm. And so the way out of that is to pick one specific thing in your life that you would actually like different. And look at, actually around that, what there is actually to notice there might be to be grateful for. Look at what step could you take to make just a little change in the direction that you actually want to go in. Mm-hmm. So that may be the way for you out of this big gray mountain that you have built for yourself called life is hard. Be specific, keep it small, and get clear about one step you can take, and then take that step. Once you've taken it, have a debrief with yourself. Look at, well, what worked about that? What did I accomplish by taking that step? What didn't work? So in other words, you'll get clear what you could then do to correct that, and then celebrate. Celebrate that you did it, because honestly, it is a very courageous thing to bring about change in your life. It mm-hmm. truly is a courageous thing. So for everyone who's watching, I really want to acknowledge you for picking a time like this to be bringing about change in your life. Just by watching this, you've already started the ripple in your life.
You know, as an expert and a coach, yes. I'm sure you hear a lot from people, I'm stuck. I just feel stuck. What does it mean to you? How do you define being stuck?
So being stuck means you're keeping yourself in the same vicious cycle, the exact one that you want to get out of. Mm-hmm. And you are feeling powerless to do anything about it. And so you define yourself as stuck. There is not an actual, you know, physical condition, stuckness.
Right.
It's what we do to us, what you do to yourself. Mm-hmm. So you are defining that there is nothing I can do to get out of this scenario. And so, for example, with the downturn in the economy, many people said, well, now my business is stuck and there's nothing I can do about it. And yet everyone I'm working with, their businesses are thriving. Mm-hmm. So the mind is unbelievably powerful. Mm-hmm. And if you listen to I'm stuck and just keep repeating it, you buy into it and then believe it. And so it's about challenging those beliefs that are going on in your mind and choosing differently. Well, what if it is possible, even in this very same economy, to actually grow my business and thrive? So you breathe through the disbelief moment of that, and then, well, what if it is possible? And then thoughts will come to you that may even seem crazy. The crazier the better, actually.
Right, like an idea of an action to take.
Exactly.
To make that possibility a reality in your business.
Exactly. And it might take being creative, and it mm-hmm. might take extra effort. and what? So it will take extra effort.
Right.
But it will get you exactly where you want to go. So it comes back to giving yourself permission to let go of that past-based thinking, like how it's always been, and believing it always will stay the same. And letting go of all that and really looking from now forward. The core essence of what I do as a coach is bringing people into this present moment now. That is an amazingly powerful way to launch yourself then, mm-hmm. catapult yourself into the future, is being fully present now. Now, let me explain what I mean by this. Just think about being at a party, for example, and you're talking to somebody who's almost present. They're almost looking at you. Yes, they might be slightly looking over your shoulder because there might be something more interesting going on over here. Mm-hmm. They're almost interested, but they might be waiting to talk, not really listening, but talking over you because they want to talk first. So that's not quite what I mean by being present. Being present would be fully listening, being fully present, mm-hmm. not being attracted or seduced by what's going on around.
Right.
That's being fully present. So imagine being that in your life right now, where you're focusing on this present moment right now, and that's all there is. You know, the past really is in the past, and it has no power over you unless you give it power. So you embrace the past. I'm not saying forget that it ever happened. That's impossible. But embrace it, but then look, where am I now? Where is it I want to get to? Being very specific about this, and then imagine that ideal outcome, and then we begin to put the plan together.
You know, it sounds so simple the way you describe it, and I really do believe that it can be that simple. Tell me a little bit about your book.
Ah, my baby. Ignite Your Life, How to Get from Where You Are to Where You Want to Be. So this is my first book, and I am delighted to talk about it. So this got created out of my desire to reach more people than I could possibly coach one-on-one. Mm-hmm. And I realized that it needed to be incredibly simple. So you'll feel me taking you by the hand. It's a very gentle book. It's a very action-oriented book. So the chapters are short, very easy to read. And like I started to say, it starts with clearing out all those limiting beliefs that have really been running the show in your life. And then from there, once we do that, you get clear about your life, how you feel about every area of your life. And then from there, it's about picking a couple of areas to focus on and creating that ideal vision. And then once you've done that, then you create the plan, and then you begin to get into action. And the last section of the book is actually how to live an ignited life. Because let's not take that for granted. If it's a bit like exercise, when you go for that first time when you haven't been exercising, it really feels strange and, let's say, a little bit painful. So it's the same thing when you haven't been living the way you may be yearning for decades. When you start to do it, you might just sabotage it. So I touch on some very simple ways to actually enjoy the journey.
Mm-hmm. Andrea, have you seen that some of your clients spend a lot of time just living in the past and having a hard time getting over things?
Yes, indeed. That is one of the biggest causes, where there has been some trauma, something negative that happened, something that they regret from the past that they didn't do, didn't accomplish, didn't see through to fulfillment. And so it can absolutely run the present if you are hauling it into the present day in, day out. So for example, let's say that you had dreamed of becoming a doctor, fill in the blank, and you gave up, or life happened and you had to take a different course. And yet what's humming in the background, just like this grinding drill in your life all the time, is what life would have been like if I'd been that doctor, if only I had, and filled with regret and or remorse. Perhaps you have gone through a difficult divorce and you were really angry at your ex. This is a very common one. And you just haul that into the present time. It gets in the way of all your relationships. Absolutely is insect repellent to attracting anyone new in your life, for sure, and has a major dramatic impact on your children, that you are still so angry at your ex, who is still their other parent.
Right.
And so to become fully present in the present moment is to do whatever you need to do to let that go. It might be forgiveness. So it might be time to forgive. It might be simply a symbolic letting go. Mm-hmm. To be right here, right now, that fully single person, that person who is now whoever you now are. You're not that doctor, but you are. This is what you are. And if you still dream of being that doctor, then there's absolutely nothing to get in your way.
Yeah, it's not too late.
It's never too late.
You know, we've heard stories all the time of people who go back and pick up where they left off.
Yes.
In this present moment. You know, it's interesting what you're talking about, because I also think that this is true, not just living in the past, but also, you know, someday when this happens, my life will start.
Exactly, yes. So for us women folk, so for example, you know, if we become too consumed with how beautiful I was all that time ago. Mm-hmm. And, you know, for example, Demi Moore, who's an amazing, talented, fabulous woman. But here's a great example of someone who's trying to stay eternally young. You know, through all of the plastic surgery, her choices in men, younger men, you know, instead of really just embracing who she is, mm-hmm, in her present, at a present age, in this present moment, would be so empowering in her life and to all of us women folk. So I also want to say about it's never too late. In this country, in the United States of America, this is the easiest place I've ever lived. I've lived in several countries of the world. Mm-hmm. To really, if you can dream it, you can do it. It truly is true here. It's never too late to go back to school here. It's easy. You can do it
You can do it at home.
In units. You can do it at home.
You can do it at home.
It's never too late. So it's about really getting clear what it is that you absolutely would be so excited you could hardly breathe, and go after that, because it's going to change your life in amazing ways and you'll be unrecognizable.
Andrea, talk to us about managing negativity in our lives.
Yes, this is one of my favorite subjects. Mm-hmm. So there are three primary sources of negativity. One is outside yourself, and it is the media. The media is designed, and by media I'm talking about specifically the news. The news.
You're not talking about this show. No, I'm just kidding.
Not this show. No, quite the opposite. This is why I'm so excited to be here.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is the exact opposite. So the news is designed to keep you hooked. It's almost like a drug. If you start to notice, like the timing and how they seed the next upcoming disaster that they're going to tell you about. Yeah, you're nodding. Really, you're nodding. This is your background, right? Mm-hmm,
it is.
And so it's such a trap if you get pulled into and sucked mm-hmm. into putting the news on, and just even if you're leaving it humming in the background,
right?
It is primarily one negative story after another, one after another after another. There is rarely any good news on the news. So resist the temptation to watch it mm-hmm. as much as you possibly can. Turn it off. I'm not saying be completely uninformed. Obviously, it's a good thing to be informed. Find ways to maybe have a small dose of news so you know what's going on in the world, but that's it. Mm-hmm. And do not watch it, because it's like a drug. It will seduce you and suck you in. So that's the external negative influence to pay attention to. So if we come in a little closer to this body called you, the next area to pay attention to is your friends and family. Your immediate close community. Now, let me be clear from the offset. I do not mean excommunicate everybody in your life.
I want to be alone.
Go find a new group, right?
You're negative.
So I don't mean that.
Somehow, but I don't think that would go over very well.
It wouldn't go over well, no. So keep your friends and family. Mm-hmm. However, pay attention to who in the midst of all these friends and family, often it's family members,
right?
Are naysayers. They say stuff to you like, well, that'll never work. Who do you think you are?
We don't know anybody who does that, do we? Right.
Yeah. Wonderful, uplifting remarks mm-hmm. like that.
Right.
So the way to handle them, to give you a strategy, is to say to them, thank you for sharing, genuinely, no sarcasm, because that will leave them nowhere to go, and then continue on the pathway that you are on. And do not let them stop you. Mm-hmm. It's an interesting thing when you start to change, is people get unsettled around you. It's like, where did Andrea go? So what you want to do is assure everyone you're still you, but you're growing and you're changing, and bring mm-hmm. them with you. So the negative ones, you want to manage them. You might want to manage how much time you spend with them. If, let's say, they're sort of a bit more distant family, if they're close family, you may become contagious by being more positive mm-hmm. and just inviting them over here in this green pasture and come play over here.
You know, I've heard studies where oftentimes, and accounts of this too, oftentimes it only takes one person inside a family or a workplace to shift their energy.
Absolutely.
And then over time, you'll see everyone in that space has a shift.
Yes.
You know, it just takes that one person to get it started.
That's correct. Mm-hmm. I say, when I go into companies and I coach the management and then the teams, is any one person can transform this whole company. So it could be the receptionist. It could be the guy in the mailroom. It could be the CEO. It could be anyone by putting a stake in the ground and being a stand for fill in the blank. Excellence, being a stand for commitment, being a stand for
enthusiasm.
I was going to say joy, right?
Right.
Just that. And it's amazing how it's felt. And it ripples on out. And you get noticed. And then, well, I'm going to be a bit more like that. Other people start rising like cream to the top, too.
Amazing.
It is amazing.
Andrea Woolf, thank you so much for being here with us on the show and sharing your expertise and your incredible book, Ignite. Thank you.
Thank you.
Are you struggling to find time and energy for your significant other or your children? Are you yearning for more in your life? Are you taking care of everyone but yourself? If this is you, then you've come to the right place. I'm Andrea Woolf, the queen of having it all, and the author of Ignite Your Life, How to Get From Where You Are to Where You Want to Be. I've been a business and personal coach for close to 20 years, and I've worked with thousands of people. From the time I was little, I would go to my mother's salon and would literally coach her clients. So I can truly say that for my whole life, I've been taking people from settling to sizzling. So what's causing the gap between where you are and where you want to be in your life? The shocking fact of the matter is this: you are the main reason you aren't getting the results you want, either from how you're thinking or how you're doing what you're doing in your life. Know that you absolutely can create success, joy, and fulfillment. All it takes is knowing how. My book, Ignite Your Life, is a simple step-by-step system that will create a profound shift in your life and will bring about the success, abundance, and joy that you've always dreamed of. Ignite Your Life takes you by the hand to uncover the limiting beliefs and fears that are keeping you stuck, help you easily manage your mind, and attract and achieve anything you want in your life and business, starting today. Also, there are two amazing bonuses. Firstly, the Light Your Fire 30-Day Challenge. You'll be reminded each and every day how great life really can be when you're taking powerful steps towards what's most important to you. And secondly, a Have It All Strategy Session with me. You'll clarify where you would like to take your life to the next level and make significant changes. This entire amazing special package, which includes my book, The Light Your Fire 30-Day Challenge, and your Have It All Strategy Session, is just $9.97. Go to my website listed here to pick it up today.